Every year, over 14 million people in the world are diagnosed with cancer. Out of them, 8 million come from Africa, Asia, India, Middle East, CIS, and other developing countries, where most people still suffer from the lack of oncological treatments. They used to be doomed. Men, women, children. But now, there is hope. Introducing Protectic, a peer-to-peer blockchain insurance platform that makes the treatment of oncological diseases affordable for millions of people from the developing world. The share economy approach makes people unite in order to save each other's lives. Blockchain technology ensures complete transparency and trust. Protectic takes a fixed operating fee and is not interested in excess profits. Thanks to this, the participants pay only small annual premiums, starting from $20, which is many times less than the cost of a regular critical illness insurance products with the same level of coverage. This contribution can be paid by an employer or charity funds. The insurance cover is up to $35,000, an amount sufficient to treat most oncological diseases. The diagnosis is confirmed by an independent consortium of doctors and by artificial intelligence in the future. After that, an optimal clinic is chosen for the patient in one of our destination countries. We will organize all treatment and rehabilitation, including travel to and from the clinic. Protectic is just the first step to build P2P insurance and healthcare ecosystems for developing countries, the most promising project of digital insurance of the near future. Protectic announces its pre-ICO stage to raise crowdfund investments for further development of the platform. Join us. Protectic. Assurance should be affordable for everyone. Let's make it happen together.
I'm Dmitry Kaminsky, co-founder of Humanic. And actually, this project Protectic, it is very reasonable to consider. When Valeria previously was explaining regarding that we are going to launch Humanic Accelerator and Humanic Crypto Liquid Venture Fund, which will support at least 10 projects which will be appointed during the next couple of months into that accelerator. Protectic is the first one, but not the only one. And this is a very good example because this company, insurance company, it will make P2P insurance in Africa for people to protect them, to defend them from death. Because everybody in Africa, every people who has cancer, they are literally sentenced to death because there is no way how to treat cancer. Not because it is not treatable. The simplest cases of cancer, they just technically are not treatable in Africa just because there are no doctors, no facilities for that. However, in Russia and in India, simple cases of cancer, they could be treated just only for $20,000. So, Protectic, in other words, it is just literally Airbnb or Uber for cancer treatment. So it will be, we will take the people from Africa, move them to Russia, and we'll treat them for $20,000. This is very simple mode, a model of business and technology, and this is how advanced tech sharing economy could be repurposed and used for Africa. Now, the Humanic itself, it's from one point of view, it is a very simple mobile application, but it's much more beyond that. I am founder of Deep Knowledge Ventures. It is a venture fund, early stage seed investment fund. My mentors are such people as Nick Bostrom from Oxford Future Humanities Institute. It is a strategist on pathways of development of artificial intelligence. Eric Drexler, founding father of nanotechnology, also he's living in Oxford. Sir Martin Rees, it is a leading scientist in UK. And Aubrey de Grey, it's actually a creator of modern geroscience, science of anti-aging and genetics of aging and age-related disease. 3 years ago, we created the Deep Learning Community of Russia. Deep Learning is an artificial community in Russia. And we supported a lot of hackathons. And first hackathons were Hack the Deaf. It was bioinformatics hackathons to analyze different patterns in genetics of cancer. So we, at that time, we invested in several projects in anti-cancer treatment. It were several projects in bioinformatics of genetics of cancer. One of our portfolio companies is in silico medicine. It is the leading company nowadays in applying deep learning for drug discovery and drug repurposing. And that we've focused on age-related disease and the genetics of aging. Now, the point of the purpose, the idea, the approach of humanity, very simple idea. Here in UK, in US, in Silicon Valley, even in Moscow, we have abundance of technology. And all this technology, it is focused on so-called golden billion. However, there are at least another 6 billion of people who has just literally lack of, not even technology, they have lack of access to just basic features of civilization. You should consider that there are 3 billion of people in the world who do not have documents. They not even do not have bank accounts. They do not have documents. And more of it, there are some estimations that there are at least 1 billion of another people who are not counted at all. So beyond that normal 7.5 billion of people which consider that they exist on the earth, there are probably at least another 1 billion people who are not formally existing at all. So humanity is just simple technology how to deliver access to any basic technologies of civilization to the people who are not existing, formerly existing, but they exist. This protection, it is one of the examples how we will deliver, how we will deploy existing technologies, existing in developed world, how we will repurpose them, retune, and will deliver to developing world. We will use Humanic as the platform, as technological platform, which will aggregate more other advanced technologies and products, and some of them, and mainly we will focus on sourcing such projects and teams, let's say leaders, technological leaders from Oxford University, Cambridge University, from other advanced technological hubs, and also from Eastern Europe, just because in Eastern Europe there are cheaper data science engineers, cheaper blockchain engineers, and we will source the talents from that parts of the world. We'll use UK as the business development platform. We'll deploy, we'll deliver that technologies through the UK as the leverage towards Africa and Latin America and other really problematic zones, because there are also approximately 30 countries which are not also existing formally. They're existing, but they're not recognized by, let's say, central banks. They do not have their currencies. I am from Moldova, and Moldova, because of civil war, was divided 20 years ago, and there is Transnistria. Transnistria is part of Moldova, which do not have central bank. They do not have any healthcare system. They have so tremendous problems, which for them even basic, they cannot buy any normal drugs for treatments, even basic diseases. So they have to do it with very complicated ways, how just to supply the people with some basic stuff. Just the same problems are in many other countries which are existing on the planet, but they do not have no access, not to banking system, not to any other advanced system. So Humanic is just a very simple idea how to use advanced technology, repurpose it to development world.
Thank you so much.